Notion have an event in October, and it's set for October 24th, and it's called Make by Notion. And it's an event that allows releases and announcements of upcoming things that are happening inside of Notion. But there is something that's sort of been leaking across the web over the last week, and it's called Notion Mail. Today we're going to see what to expect and what could come of these plans that they have or have come across on the internet and leaked already this week. Hello everyone, my name is Francesco D'Alessio, welcome to the channel. If you're new, do subscribe. And also, if you did want to check out the top-ranked note-taking apps report that we've just released, you can find it linked below to get some insights on all of those apps and tools ranked. So Notion have had this concept of a productivity suite for some time now, and it really began in June of 2022 when they acquired a company called Cron Calendar. They essentially took Cron Calendar and in January 2024 turned it into Notion Calendar, which was the first piece of the puzzle in a multiverse of applications that Notion planned to release. Notion continued this acquisition by purchasing in February 2024 a company called Skiff, which, for those who don't know, is literally a light rowing boat or sculling boat, typical for one person. But Skiff essentially was a combination of experiences from Pages to Drive all the way to email and calendar, and it was really fast and focused on security, many people actually moving to it as a more secure way to base their work. So essentially they discontinue that, and naturally, once the acquisition happened, they announced that they will be sunsetting that on August the 9th. And in the last week, some things have come out. The Mail logo has been touted, a developer domain has been found, and a few other pointing evidence, like, for example, in their agenda, they have a section on a new Notion product, and that new Notion product is run by their engineering lead, who used to be the CEO of Skiff. So, writing's on the table, with Notion Mail potentially coming. Obviously, total speculation, but a few of the things are hinting towards it. So let's take a look at what Skiff had in their mail experience that could potentially port over and give you some of my expectations, what I think is planned. So Skiff had a lot of focus on encrypted mail. End-to-end encryption of your emails was something they touted and was something they brought to the table. They also had something where you had a custom domain, which means you had an @skiff.com email address, which allows you to email from that domain with security in mind. But you could also attach custom domains as well. Now, there were other applications as part of this. Pages, Drive, and Calendar were all part of this lineup, allowing you to create documents like you would in Notion, also store files like you would in Google Drive, and manage your calendar like you would in a calendar application. But it was very much security focused. So these are the things that I think that Notion Mail will have included in it. Obviously, these are my thoughts based on what I know about Skiff. I was one of the first people to cover Skiff on YouTube, and also very much kept updated with the experience. So the first of those, I think, is a Gmail connection. Connecting your Gmail is something that opens the market up for so many different things. I think including Outlook, being able to bring your email into that experience that you already have is something that I think the likes of Notion Mail will have. It is something that naturally was built into Cron Mail, was built into Cron Calendar, so something that I think they'll definitely have from day one. I think there'll be custom domain options, and I'm not sure whether there'll be a big focus on security, only because previously there hasn't been that much focus on security or end-to-end encryption when looking at other Notion products. However, that could be a nice addition and something that a lot of people would want. I think from there, there'll be a better connection to your calendar. I've seen other apps like SmartMail recently bring in a calendar and email in one location, and it just looks really good. And I think because Notion Calendar is out there and the likes of Notion Mail will be out there, I think that's a natural transition. And plus the fact that Skiff Calendar was available before, you could potentially have a nice transition there. As that new product announcement and digging a little bit deeper into the productivity suite is brought to you by the Skiff team, they also mentioned in brackets that there will be AI help inside of this new Notion product. So how do I think that AI will be brought into Notion Mail? Well, I think it will be a little bit like Shortwave, where there'll be an assistant on the side, which help you to plan your calendar, but also help you to plan and search for your emails, which can be really helpful. Also, summarizing your emails using AI is something that's going to save you a bunch of time. Now, one of the questions people probably have is this going to be priced? And in my opinion, I think it will be. I actually worked several years ago in 2016 to 2018 with Newton Mail. And it's surprising how much the costs of an email app rack up, because you've got so many different things, especially if we're trying to do things like reducing email tracking or end-to-end encryption. I think those costs might add up. So I think this might be the first out-of-the-box premium product that Notion offer, just because they know that market. Calendar apps, people are a little bit more, they like having them, but they're not as willing to pay compared to something like email, I think. So I think companies will obviously like this, but also individuals will like this too. So I think that will be a definite premium product that Notion offers. So those are my thoughts. And it finally brings me to one big question at the end. Why is Notion doing this? Well, I think, in my opinion, they bet a lot of their focus on Notion itself. And that's good. But the entire suite of productivity is very much structured. Notion is very much a build your own layout. And for some people, that's good. And they will keep that product. There's no doubt about it. But other people, structure matters to their daily productivity. It also makes things like organizing your email and managing your email with artificial intelligence probably much easier for the LLM to understand versus a very disjointed experience they could have weaved into the likes of Notion. So I see Calendar, Mail, and other tools in the future like Chat. That's one of my things that is on the cards. They've got a big chance to beat Slack here, in my opinion, being these products that are AI-centric and have better structure for that AI to build on. So that's why I think they're doing it. It's fixing the structure issue that they've had for a long time. So thank you very much. I hope you enjoyed this video. Again, if you're not subscribed, do subscribe. And also, do check out that ranked note-taking apps. I'm sure you'll love the report. You can get it sent to your email and join our newsletter at the same time. So thank you very much, and I'll see you all very soon, I'm sure. Cheerio.